to Doak Campbell Stadium, home to the Florida State Seminoles, and just listen to this crowd energy. Every Seminoles game, the war chant goes full throttle. Today we have a top 25 matchup on hand. Two of college football's premier teams preparing to battle against one another. As we'll see, the number 13 team in the country, the LSU Tigers, taking on the 11th ranked team, the Florida State Seminoles. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here in the booth by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, let's get to the action on the field. Kickoff team has come on the field now to send this one away. Looks like he'll try to make a play with the return. And the coverage team gets the returner to the ground. So the Seminoles special teams don't do the offense any favors with that return. And here comes one of the elite running backs in all of college football. When he gets the ball in his hands, it's just hold your breath time, Kirk. He's been electrifying.
He sure is. The embodiment of a superstar. The bona fide.
That deep shot is caught for a big game. And they'll bring him down, but this offense creates a huge chunk play.
Good job here by the quarterback putting that ball in the air where the receiver can make a play on it. And I tell you, Florida State has had some great receivers over the years, and this kid is really living up to that.
See what the call is on first and 10. Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. The pickup is 5 yards, so it's second down and 5.
Here early in the game, the defense right away realizes what they're up against. Having an opportunity to move this receiver around, give him a chance to get out in space, are the plays that can really cause a defensive coordinator headaches.
The game makes it second and medium. Oh, a reverse. And they'll tackle him for a loss of 5 yards.
The defense there showed incredible discipline on the backside contain, and that reverse wasn't going anywhere. Just textbook.
Offense been in reverse here. Now a long way to go to convert this third down. Play action fake. Looking to throw. Here's a shot toward the end zone. The ball is picked off.
Hey, these guys have been giving up some plays. I mean, this offense looked pretty good. They're moving the ball, but they get them to third down. They get pressure on the quarterback. Quarterback panics, puts that ball into coverage, and this defense comes up with that big interception.
And this crowd coming to life here, trying to help the defense get a stop. The offense pinned back. It's an option look. Pitches to the back. And this is going to be a safety.
Well, that's how you get a game started by this defense. What a way to score here early. We'll just have to see if these 2 points make much of a difference if this game ends up coming down to the wire.
Kickoff team out there to boot it away after giving up the safety. With the return, it's Hill. And here comes the Florida State offense on the field. They had it going on the last drive, but it ended abruptly with the interception. Let's see what they can do here. Now begin with a quick throw to the left. They get him down quickly, not much of a gain on that completion.
Well, anytime an offensive coordinator calls a wide receiver screen, he's trying to get offensive linemen out in front of the receiver to create a wall so that receiver can pick a lane to run through. How about the defense here, though? That's called team pursuit and swarming to the football. They didn't give him any lanes, so not much yards downfield for the receiver.
And they'll tackle him for a loss of 5 yards.
Well, the back just had nowhere to go. How about the defensive line? They eat up all the blocks up front, freeing those linebackers up to be able to make the play. Just a bad play all around for this offense.
The offense now facing a third and long from the 26. Got to avoid a mistake here. Looking to throw. It's Uiagalelei. Oh, a nice play by the defender. Got a hand in there to break up the pass.
Boy, this quarterback is really rolling the dice out here today. Remember, he threw an interception the last time they had the ball. I thought he might learn from that, but instead he comes out throwing it into coverage again, somehow catches a break on this tip ball that this one was an interception. He better tighten up his decision-making. He's going to cost himself a game.
And they've got the returner corralled. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. Remember the last time out there, they surrendered a safety. They got to regroup from that right away. They bring him down just short of the marker, inches away from a first down.
Love those positive yards on first and 10, and it's not quite a first down. Looks like it'll bring second and inches, but sure does open up the playbook here to be able to open up, maybe take a shot downfield.
Come to the line for second down and very short now. Receiver in motion now. Handoff from the shotgun. Brought down, but it's past the line to gain.
Chris, I know when we think about LSU, we go back to 2019. Joe Burrow, Ja'Marr Chase, Justin Jefferson. That dynamic offense. But at the end of the day, it's still LSU. It's still the SEC. And ground and pound is something they will never move away from. Great job here, and move the sticks.
There's the handoff. It's a two-yard gain, second and eight coming up.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. And the quarterback keeps it on the option. The sophomore with a strong tackle there.
Well, not exactly the outcome this offense was hoping for here on the option. They didn't lose any yards, which is great. I think they're definitely looking for more from that play.
Offense trying to move into scoring position if they can convert third and short here from the 50. To throw, it's Nussmeier. Catch made on the out route. And he'll head out of bounds, but not before picking up enough for a first down.
Well, when you play zone defense on third down and you don't get pressure from your defensive line, you're going to give a quarterback a lot of time to be able to find an open receiver and eventually get the first down. Not surprised at all that they're able to convert.
Trying to find some room. It's Williams. Fights through a tackle. And he's able to find some room before they finally bring him down.
Man, you know, the back gets a lot of the attention here. I mean, he's a good back. I love to see that offensive line win the battle of the line of scrimmage.
Offense getting set up. Here's second down. And the quarterback drops back, looking for an open man. Caught quickly. Take it down, but not before he makes the first down.
Well, a lot of times when a quarterback sees man defense, he wants to get the ball out of his hands as quickly as possible. Put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle or two on the outside and get a big play.
LSU getting set with a first and 10 now. Caught over the middle. It's Lacy. Defense will make the stop and what will probably be the final play of this opening quarter. As we break for the quarter, Kirk, Florida State is on top. And at the end of the first quarter, let's check out the stats so far. They've flipped ends of the field. We're ready now for the second period. Second down after that previous play. We're trying to run it with the option. And the quarterback can't even get the pitch off. That play goes nowhere. They're backed up here, trying to make something happen on third and long. Dropping back, they're going to throw for the first down. Defense breaks it up. Nice play. Incomplete.
Hey, it's an incompletion, but it's a nice job by the quarterback. I know it didn't pan out, but the most important thing is he didn't turn the football over and he didn't take a sack. It'll give your kicker a chance to put some points on the board if they opt for the field goal here on fourth down.
The decision is not to go for it on fourth down. Here comes the field goal team. This will be a 45-yard attempt. The kick is good. He knocked it right down the middle.
Yeah, I was watching this guy in pregame. He has got a strong leg. Not surprised here he's able to put 3 points up here for the offense.
So after the field goal, the kicker out there again to boot it away. And here's the return from inside the five. He'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. And the Florida State offense heads back onto the field. Last time was a quick three and out. Can they get a drive going this time? Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2. Well, they run it right into a blitz, and that linebacker was coming downhill, Kirk.
Man, what a time to call that blitz here by the defensive coordinator. And you're right, he shoots right through that A-gap. Really, the back had nowhere to go. By the time he got the ball in his hands, the linebacker's right in his face.
They got some ground to make up, second and long from the 15. Tackled behind the line, it's a loss of 2. So the counter play doesn't work. The defense in good position that time to make a play.
You know, on most of these counters, you leave the in man on the line of scrimmage unblocked and you try to pull those offensive linemen to kick him out. But if you have an aggressive defense, sometimes that can backfire, and the defense knew exactly what was coming there.
Drops back, looking to throw for it on third down. But they don't connect. It's incomplete, and it brings up fourth down.
Boy, this is all about the defense here. Nice stop here on third down, but really it's about trying to get this offense behind the sticks. Once you get him behind the sticks, you can mix up your coverages, really affect the quarterback's eyes and disrupt the timing and the rhythm of what the offense is trying to do. Now we've got another big fourth down coming up.
No, kick it away here. He's got an opening. Watch out. He's got great speed. The returner is brought down. There is a flag on the field, so we'll check out this call. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. The offense will keep going here after that special teams penalty. Trying to flex the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff.
Hey, listen, you don't always have to have big plays to be successful. It's a nice, solid gain here. Keeps you on schedule, and you get ready for that next play.
Here's the second down play. Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. Tackle made, but there's a flag down on the field. That one hurts. Backs him up 10 yards. Second down play coming up for this offense. They call the draw play here. Breaking tackles. Tackle finally made. That's a very solid gain, but not close to first down yardage yet.
The draw is a good way to keep the defensive line in check and use their aggressiveness against them. It can be real effective, even in passing situations, if you mix it incorrectly.
Offense needing to keep this drive alive. It's a third down play. Looking to pass. It's Uiagalelei. Running back grabs it on the screen. Good job by the defense to fight through the blocks on that screen. He's short of the first down marker. Made the catch, but he was surrounded, Kirk. Not much room to run.
They did a really good job that time of leveraging him out in space. I thought he might have a chance to be able to shake loose because he is so elusive. But defense, as you said, did a really good job in the open field surrounding him. Just nowhere for him to go to pick up any more positive yards.
Bringing it back, it's Thomas. And the coverage team pins him in and brings him down. And that Bayou Bengals offense is back out on the field. They'd love to stretch the lead here with a touchdown. Had to settle for 3 last time. They stop him after a 6-yard gain. So 2nd and 4.
I tell you, to be able to pick up a nice gain like that, those offensive linemen have to sustain their blocks. Gave them a chance at a really nice gain.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Here's the snap, looking to throw here. And the sophomores got him for a sack.
Oh, my goodness. That looked to be the defensive back who came flying up there to put the pressure on the quarterback.
So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Dropping back, we're going to throw for the first down. It's a screen pass complete to the running back. Defense makes the stop. The screen pass doesn't produce a first down, and now it's fourth down.
Now there's just nothing here for the quarterback to do other than throw it to his back and hope that he can get the yards after the catch enough for the first down. But the defense gives some yards, but not enough for him to get to the sticks.
Now the timeout is called by the defense. They've got some things to work out here. And the punt team makes its way onto the field. Oh, it landed at the 8-yard line, but a lucky bounce into the end zone for a touchback. First down here, time for one more play before the clock stops for the 2-minute warning. He's stopped just short of that first down marker, inches away from it. That's the 2-minute warning in this close first half. The offense trying to score and claim the lead before the break. Second down after that run on the previous play. To throw, it's Uiagalelei. That's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no flag, brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out the punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, he's unable to hold on to the football.
So ball at the 30. This is a manageable third down play for the offense. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. That one is incomplete. The defender was right there, and it brings up fourth down now.
Boy, third down and short. They decide to throw the football, roll the dice a bit, doesn't work out. Now you're at fourth and short. You got to wonder, with this offensive line and this running back, do you run the football to convert, or do they try to go through the air again?
And at fourth down, they'll punt it away here. And the coverage team able to bring the returner to the ground. Okay, so here comes the LSU offense back on the field. They had to punt the ball last time. Now they're looking to add points, build on this lead. Grab down the middle. It's Lacy. They bring him down, but he was fast enough to get that first down yardage. That's a nice pickup there. They find some space in the zone and pick up the first down.
Yeah, really nice call here, Chris, to be able to pick up this first down on this drag route. The quarterback does a nice job of being patient, waiting for that window to open up in that zone, and he put it right on the money for the receiver to have a chance to not just catch it, but eventually get the first.
Makes a quick grab. Defense surrounds him. Just a short gain on that completion.
Love the timing here between the quarterback and his receiver. Pick up some positive yards, and I continue to be impressed with just the chemistry between these two.
Pass complete. It's second down now. Quarterback drops back, probing the secondary. Caught over the middle. It's Williams. They've got him, but that completion good enough for first down yardage. The offense will take their first time out of the half to talk strategy here. The offense finally producing here. Sets up a first and 10. Quick throw. Catch made on the out route. They bring him down, but a solid gain there on first down. Looks to be just inches short of the marker.
Chris, it's so much fun to watch the athleticism at the wide receiver position nowadays. The ability to make plays on the outside is extraordinary. And they bring a certain toughness, too, that catches my eye.
To the air. It's Nussmeier. He finds his man. They bring him down, but not before he gains first down yardage. The offense will quickly spend a timeout here after the play.
This offense has become a first down machine, and that's so demoralizing for a defense. especially for those star players who don't sub out as much. But a fourth quarter really starts to wear you out.
The offense calls a timeout here. That's their third and final of the half. So the offense looking to be efficient here. Not much time remaining before the end of the half. Quarterback looking to throw it on second down. Let's it fly to the wideout. Caught near the goal line. And he's in. Touchdown, LSU. So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. With the PAT, that makes the score 10-2. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. So an important touchdown just before halftime. Not much time for the opposing offense to try to answer before the break. Final 9 seconds of the half as they line up here in first and 10. Try to catch the defense with the draw. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2. Minnesota's going to wrap up the first half here. Let's kick it now to Kevin Connors with our halftime update.
Man, it should come as no surprise we have ourselves a fun matchup in Tallahassee. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. It's time to throw it back to our guys in the booth to start up the second half.
The Seminoles will kick this away to get the second half going. And the kickoff will be returned. And he stopped at the 19. Good job by the coverage team. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. First play of the second half, they keep it on the ground. Nothing doing in that play. The big D tackle there for the stop.
That was an excellent effort by this defense, just staying in their run fits, holding their own at the line of scrimmage, and then making a tackle. Offense just couldn't get enough of a push to get any yards at all.
Important second down play coming up. Quarterback pulls the ball. It's a keeper.
Not exactly the outcome this offense was hoping for here on the option. I'll give them credit. They didn't lose anything, so it wasn't a negative play. But this kind of play's got to be able to hit big and get down the sidelines for big yards.
They come to the line. A long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. Back to pass. It's Nussmeier. Quick throw, testing the middle. There's a wide open receiver, complete. That'll pick up first down yardage very near the 40.
Well, this quarterback is unflappable. Here they are working with the lead in the second half. Get to a third down. You got to throw the football. This is where you trust the quarterback to make a good decision, an accurate throw. He does it. You convert, and you keep working that clock.
Ball handed off. Tackle is made very near midfield. Good enough for a first down. This offense continues to roll. We wondered, would this defense come up with some answers at halftime? Not on that play.
No, they've tried to make every adjustment they can. This offense has been very impressive with the way they're able to keep this ball on the ground, churning out big yards. I think they're gaining more confidence, really, as this game goes on.
Throws to the tight end. Finds a man downfield. It's a big gain to the right. Tackle is finally made, but it's down at the 28-yard line.
Boy, it's great to see this quarterback from LSU make that throw and put it right on the money to pick up that first down. And I think that's the big thing that LSU fans want to see is consistency from the quarterback position. There have been moments where you've seen that. There have been other moments where they've been asking for more out of their quarterback. So you had the Burrow moment in 2019 that was historic, one of the best we've ever seen in the sport. But now you want to see throws like this and be a great complement to that running game. And then you become a complete package and a real threat in the SEC.
Second down after that short completion. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to throw. Caught behind the line. It's Thomas. Defense makes the stop after the completion.
Just a good job here by the quarterback. Got the ball out to his receiver. His guy eats up some yards. They stay ahead of the sticks.
And here comes the noise. This crowd is trying to inspire this defense to make a big red zone stop. They'll try to move the chains here on the ground. Got space, looking to score. And he runs it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tigers.
Chris, he broke free from the line of scrimmage. I thought he might have a 10 or 15 yard gain, but he shows you the speed that he has to take it all the way to the house.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. Went after makes it a 15-point game. Here's the kickoff team. Let's see if they give the returner an opportunity to bring this back. He'll return it from inside the five. And he stopped at the 19. Good job by the coverage team. And the Seminoles offense comes back on the field. The sack in the play could not escape the pass rush.
Well, I love this defense and how they're playing some man coverage. And let's face it, when you do that, it's a bit risky. You can leave your defensive backs out there on islands, but the good combination of good coverage with a good pressure on the quarterback, and you come up with sacks like this.
They lose yards on first down, so second and long from the 16. They're going to run it. They'll tackle him out across the 20.
I'll take that every single time. Offensive line does a nice job up front. This back's vision and ability to get positive yards by lowering his pads on full display right there.
Urgency now for the offense that hates to come up empty on this drive down multiple scores. Dropping back, it's Uiagalelei. Quick throw to his receiver. It's caught downfield. They bring him down, but that's a good play. Moves the ball to the 39.
This is a big conversion by this offense. They're down now in the second half. Probably limited opportunities at this point in the game. Every chance you get your hands on the ball, you need points. They keep this drive alive right here.
The Noles begin a new series here, first and 10. There's the snap, and he's looking to throw. With the catch, it's Lee.
Well, the defense didn't have any time at all to get pressure on the quarterback. He gets the ball out of his hands pretty quickly on the hitch to the receiver.
That completion makes it second and medium. From the shotgun, drops back looking for an open man. Looks downfield and finds a receiver who worked his way wide open. Explosive gain across midfield. They'll spot it about the 35.
My gosh, this receiver is outstanding. A huge play for this Florida State offense. And Ted, you and I have been coming into Tallahassee a long time. We've seen some great receivers. Guys like Johnny Wilson, most recently, a big, tall target. Anquan Boldin could do everything. Maybe one of my favorite players of all time, Peter Warwick. And going back to Fred Biletnikoff, played, of course, in Florida State.
What's the play call here on second down for this offense? It's LSU on top as we take a break for the quarter. And they got to be feeling pretty good about things as we wrap up the third quarter. Let's review how we got here. So one final quarter to play. It's going to take a lot to turn this game around, but strange things do happen in college football. Back to throw. It's Uiagalelei. Looking to set up a screen pass here. And they'll bring him down. The defense fought through the blocks, and they stop him short of the first down.
Interesting call here, Chris, with a screen pass in the fourth quarter late in the game. I think they're expecting the defense to get upfield on the pass rush. But give the defense all the credit. Recognizing it, almost really anticipating that this screen was coming, and then rallying to the ball.
Drops back, looking to throw for it on third down. And it's complete downfield. They bring him down, but that's a solid gain on the play.
I love to see this team fighting the way they are. Picking up a first down on that third down shows you they still believe. They still think they got a shot to come back and compete in this game.
And the Noles are in the red zone. From the shotgun, an inside handoff. Coming to the line on second down, this is important. They want to avoid a third and long. Makes the grab on the move. Finally out of bounds after a solid gain, but there is a flag on the field. So let's check this out. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. Offense getting set. It's second down. A pop pass on the jet sweep.
Man, that jet sweep action puts so much pressure on a defense. You get so locked in on the ball attacking you downhill. But when offenses sprinkle this kind of offense in, it stretches this defense out wide and can create some vertical seams for big plays.
Crucial. Third down coming up in the red zone. Can they keep the drive going, or will they have to settle for three? From the shotgun, it's a handoff. He's stopped short of the marker, so it's fourth down now. The offense stays on the field, down multiple possessions. Easy choice. Fourth down. He's throwing for it. He's got it right near the end zone. And he scores. Touchdown, Seminoles. And now here comes the point after attempt. PAT is good. They still trail, though. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. Fields it just outside the goal line. He'll be tackled at the 18. That's good coverage there. and that Bayou Bengals offense is back out on the field. This game just got tighter. The temptation might be to sit on this lead, but we'll see how aggressive they get. It's an out route, the catch made. They make the tackle, but that pass creates a solid gain.
Chris, that's another nice pickup through the air. I thought they might be really just out to run the football here with the lead. But instead, they're electing to throw the football. Different routes, quarterbacks in rhythm. Really, it's almost an extension of their passing game.
They'll work the clock here with the running game. Refusing to be brought down. They bring him down, but a big chunky yardage on the play. Looks like a player is down injured at that last play. We'll take a timeout while they check it out. The offense is clicking, and the defense just searching for answers now. On first down, they'll keep their running game churning.
I like the run play here. And offensively, at this point in the game, you want to remain in that attack mode first while also staying in bounds and working that clock.
Offense getting set. Second down play here. Keep it on the ground. There's the handoff. Fights through the tackle. Brought down after a solid run by the senior.
You know, sometimes, Chris, we get caught up in the speed and the quickness, and obviously those are important assets to have as a running back. But what you just saw from this guy, and he's had a pretty good day, is his ability to break tackles in the open space. And he gets through those arm tackles. You can see what he's capable of doing after being able to shake free with the speed that he has.
On the ground, it's Williams. Picks up two, so it's second and eight.
Positive yards are always important for an offense, but at this stage of the game, late in the ball game, playing with the lead, you're thinking about working that clock and continuing to keep the ball in bounds.
Second down here, time for perhaps just one more play before the two-minute warning. We head now to the two-minute warning as this offense tries to bleed out the clock and secure this win. Getting set. Here's second down. Here comes the handoff. And they finally stop him, but a decent gain that time. And now it's the defense that calls timeout here, trying to get organized and preserve as much clock as possible. Big third down play. If they can't get the stop, they have to consider calling a timeout. He hands it off from the gun. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one. And now a timeout taken by the defense trying to preserve as much clock as possible for their offense. So on fourth down, out trots the place kicker in a very big spot here. And he knocks it right through the uprights. And that will extend their lead even further. Following the field goal, the kickoff team is out there now. And he takes this from inside the five. And they stop him at the 23. That's solid coverage. And here comes the Florida State offense on the field. The passing game was so effective in the last possession, right down for a touchdown. We'll see if the defense can make adjustments. Grab down the middle. It's Douglas. Tackle made after a solid gain. They'll spot the ball at the 34.
Boy, this receiver in the slot is giving this defense all kinds of problems. He has another catch on the day. You may want to adjust out, get out of your base, maybe try five or six defensive backs on the field, somebody that can match up more athletically against this slot receiver.
And looking to throw now on first down. Catch made on the out route. And he'll get the first down yards before they finally bring him down.
You know, each receiver brings something a little bit different to the table, Chris.
To me, the outside receivers usually are a little bit longer, taller guys. You get those slot receivers in the inside, not only can they make the catch, but they have quickness to make plays after the catch. Great example of that right here.
Looking to pass, it's Uiagalelei. Looks left and finds his target there. They stopped the receiver, but that's a solid gain on that play.
Well, we just continue to see this defense make great plays, especially with their tackling. And the awareness to understand we're in the fourth quarter, you're trying to keep this offense in bounds so they keep that clock moving.
They'll hurry to the line here with the clock running. They come up and quickly spike it, stopping the clock. It's third down for the offense. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. Grab near the sticks. It's Douglas. The game picks up the first down, tackled at the 37.
Easy route, easy throw for the quarterback. Good decision here by the offensive coordinator on third and short to just get the ball to the playmaker, make that catch, and pick up the first down.
So it's a first down here. The clock is stopped temporarily, but they'll get to the line quickly. The offense spikes the ball here, looking to preserve as much clock as they can. Now it's second down here. And the quarterback dropping back. The pass rush closing in. And with nobody open, he chooses to just throw it away. This was a promising drive, but back-to-back incompletions makes it third and 10. Looking downfield, it's Uiagalelei. Contact as he threw it, and it's incomplete. Just 10 seconds remaining now.
Well, the defense picks the right time to get after this quarterback. Third down, critical down and distance, do a good job of dialing things up, and good coverage downfield. He didn't have anywhere to go with the ball.
So down by multiple possessions here, the offense will try to convert here on fourth down. And he finds his target. He has the first. And a timeout stops the clock with just 7 seconds remaining in the game. And the Seminoles will line up on first and 10. Looking to throw it from the red zone. Bringing pressure. Still trying to corral this quarterback. And he'll be brought down.